Hello everybody, I'm John from Sylvester Solutions, and in this video I will show you a solution to a challenge that many Arduino users face. The challenge is, how do you get live data from your Arduino into a PC file? This file can then be used for post-processing of your data in Excel or in other applications. The solution I'm about to present to you is a very simple solution. It does not require any programming on the PC side, and on the Arduino side, the amount of code you have to add to your sketch is below 10 lines of code. So, if you're interested, please watch. And I will show you how to do it. A good demo requires a simple case. And this case you see in front of you consists of one glass of water and a temperature sensor that is submerged in the water. The idea of this demo, the challenge of this demo, is to measure the temperature of the water and record this in a file. Let's take a look at the code you need on the Arduino side. The sketch you see in front of you has two parts. It has a part to manage the sensor, and it has a part that makes the data available to the application I will show later on, and this is called WWLIP. WWLIP stands for Watch Window Library. So first, let's take a look at the code necessary to get the data from the sensor into the Arduino. First, you include the headers. Then you create a one wire and a $ temperature object. You initialize the sensor object, the $ temperature object, as such that it does not wait until the data arrive when you call the function request temperatures. And then the last thing you do is you read the value of the temperature in the variable called temperature. In order to make the data available to WWLIP, you include the appropriate header, you create a WWI serial USB object, and you initialize this object. The parameters to initialize the object are the serial port you want to use, the name of a function, and a name for your data channel you can choose yourselves. Of course, you need to initialize your serial port if you want to transfer data through your serial port, but there are also possibilities to transfer data over Wi-Fi or over Ethernet. This function is a function that is essential to share your variables with WWLIP. So over here you see the variable temperature. And making a variable available to WWLIP requires only one line of code. You have to call the WWIVAR member function of the WWI serial USB object. And the parameter of this call is the name of the variable you want to share. You can share as much variables as you want. You can even share arrays or fields of structures. If you want to share an additional variable, the only thing you have to do is add one line of code to this function. That's all that is necessary. Communication is not loaded if you add more variables, only the data you will select on the PC application I will show later on, goes through your serial bus. Let's take a look at the part that is necessary in the loop function. The most important function you need to call is loop, because within this function, within the member function loop of the Wowie SRV object, the data processing is done. It consists of two things. The PC will poll, will send a message to your Arduino requesting data, and then the Arduino sketch will answer with the appropriate values. It is also possible to send data messages to the PC on the initiative of the sketch of the Arduino, but this is a detail I will not discuss in this demo. The last function that remains is the delay function, because we have to wait in the sketch a little bit between request temperatures and get temp by C index, and we use Wowie SRV dot delay and not the Arduino delay, because if you use Wowie SRV dot delay, the processing of the requests by the PC continue, whereas in a normal delay function, the standard delay function of the Arduino IDE, processing of the messages is put on hold. Okay, that is all that is necessary. So let's put this sketch into Arduino processor and take a look at what is necessary on the PC side to get things working. Okay, let's take a look at WowieLeap. So I installed WowieLeap, default install, nothing special. And when you start it, you see something like this. So here you have the output window. Here you have a grid where you can enter the names of the variables that are of interest to you. It has a menu bar, status bar down below, standard things. The first thing we are going to do is we are going to make a connection with our board. We are going to set up communication. As you remember, the 115,200 is the baud rate we used to initialize the serial port on the Arduino side. In fact, it's a serial port that goes over USB, as you know. So this is the parameter we are going to use to initialize communication, and down below you see that it's COM18 that is used. So the first thing you do is you go to settings, communication interfaces, and you activate the dialog box. Dialog box has two tabs, a tab for UDP and TCP/IP and Wi-Fi, and then a tab for serial communication. Over here you set the baud rate, the parity and the stop bits. These are the default Arduino settings. Here you select the type of board you're communicating with, because the serial ports of different boards tend to behave differently. And over here you select the serial port. Now, if by accident you don't know the exact parameters, you can select multiple and you press add. So down below you see a list of all combinations and settings that you selected. Okay. And then you press start scan. And now WowieLeap is going to check and test all the possible settings you have enumerated in your dialog box, and it will show the ones that are working, and those that are not working it will show also. So here you see that on COM18 it found an empty demo Arduino, and on the other serial ports it did not find anything, and the proper settings are these settings. With remove inactive, you remove the settings that were scanned unsuccessfully, you press OK, and now your communication settings have been activated properly. You press setup, and then the toolbar immediately switches to loop, because our Arduino is no longer in its setup function, it's in its loop function. The next thing we are going to do is we are going to enter the name of the variable I thought it was temperature. And as you can see, already Bobby Leap is showing us the actual value. You can see the communication that is being exchanged with the Arduino board. So if you really would like to know whether it's working or not, you can see this in this way. Here down below you also see the message counter, and here you see that the interface is in its status ETF loop, which means that it's communicating. But for the moment the actual value is not displayed as it should. So let's change the format to float. So our water has a temperature of 22.8 degrees centigrade. Okay, let's reactivate the webcam for a demo. Okay, I have reactivated my webcam, and in the same time the temperature has changed a little bit, because as you might have seen in the beginning of the demo, there was a glass with ice in the view. The ice had melted, so I have to get new ice. Now the idea is that I will pour the blocks of ice in the water, and normally the temperature, where you see over here, should decrease. Okay. And as you can see, the temperature decreases, so the laws of physics still work. But now we don't have a recording yet, so let's start and configure a data recorder. Therefore you go to data recording. Bobby Leap immediately gives you a proposal for a recorder name. You choose the data file format. We want to overwrite the current data file if we go online again. So each time we go online, the file will be overwritten. Other possibilities are to append the data to the file, or create a new file with a file name that contains the moment when you went online on your Arduino, so you can have multiple files. But this is for another demo. You press add. Over here you see the time base. The time base is default 1 second, but you can modify this. If you want 2 seconds, you do an update and then you see it's 2 seconds. You can add the date, the time, or a relative timestamp, but we are only interested in the time. We are not going to do a multi-day recording. The date and the time in universal time we are also not going to out. So, but this is for if you want to prevent a problem that if you go from daylight savings time to another time that your data don't fit anymore. But these are all too many details. Conclusion is very simple. You select the appropriate file type, overwrite, you press out, and you're done. Good. Now we are going to select the data recorder we just made. Restart loop, and if all goes well it should start recording, and you see over here that the records are created and they are written to a disk file. I'm waiting for the value to change a little bit. Okay, the value has changed. So normally for the moment we should be able to have open the disk file and see which values we have recorded. Therefore we stop, and then Bobby Leap says the file is saved at this location. Okay, I'm going to deactivate the camera, and let's take a look if the values we see over here correspond with what we have in our file. Okay, let's take a look. Where do we have it over here? Documents. Ah, documents. And here we have a Wawi recorder.xlsx. And over here you see already the data, and indeed it started with 16.25 and it ended with 16. So yeah, what we have recorded is correct, huh? And this file can immediately be opened in Microsoft Excel. You don't have to do any file conversions or format conversions or whatever. It's also possible to record in comma separated value files, as you see over here, or XML. If you're a fan of XML, you can use also these formats as well. Another possibility is to limit the disk size. This is if you want to record over multiple days, for example, if you some kind of greenhouse that you want to monitor. And the last thing that can be of interest to you, that is, you can disable recording time based, and then it will only record if the value of one of your variables changes. One of the variables that is in this data recorder. So if you have, for example, four temperatures and an event in configured in one data recorder, then you can configure it as such that only if the event happens, that data will be recorded. Good, I think that's enough for this demo for today. Thank you very much and see you back next time. And of course, if you want to have additional information, you can go to our website, download our application and start working with it. If you have any questions, you can contact us. And if there are things we can do for you or you need additional support, please contact us and we will provide the necessary support. So thank you very much for watching and see you back next time.